Yeah. And if you're you ever wonder what you're doing here, you know, some people, and many times we ask that question, right? What are we doing here? What are we doing on earth? We are to manifest the kingdom of God on earth. We are God's representatives on earth, manifesting his kingdom. And his kingdom is not just on earth, it's in heaven too. So we'll talk about that a little bit. As I said, we've been talking about the manifest kingdom manifestation, what that means, what that means to us. Jesus preached something called the gospel of the kingdom of God. So there is a gospel that we are to be spreading. And God gave us a Jesus gave us a mandate. Preach the gospel, right? The good news. So there is a good news of the kingdom that Jesus preached a lot. He said the kingdom is like this, the kingdom is like that. And he gave, even in his parables and his teaching to his disciples, he mentioned the kingdom of God. Because that's where we're at. That's where we belong. So Jesus preached this gospel of the kingdom. And he said that this gospel would be preached in the whole world before the end of the age. Are on the living in those days.
What is that scripture?
The scripture is Matthew 24:14. He said that this gospel of the kingdom will be preached in the whole world before the end of the age.
But that's the problem. Not many people are preaching the kingdom.
Exactly. Well, you would think, oh, but Jesus being preached everywhere. Well, is the kingdom, and is the good news of the kingdom.
Yes, yeah.
That is how we live forever, right? But to say it in the King James Version, and this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in the whole world for a witness to all nations. And then the end shall come. So he didn't say, and when everybody's saved, then that the end will come. It says that when the kingdom is free in the whole world. What manifesting the kingdom is. We are manifesting the kingdom by preaching those good news that we live forever. Isn't that good news to somebody? When you can, how do you start a conversation, right? Hey, do you know we live forever? Did you know that? Oh, well, yeah, really? Yes, let me tell you. Let me tell you about the kingdom of God. Because that's what Jesus died, so that we can have eternal life. And we already have eternal life. So that's good news. Gospel means good news. The word gospel means good news. So what is this gospel of the kingdom? Is it the same as the gospel of salvation? Salvation is a part of the message of the kingdom of God. It's a part. We can't say, no, we don't preach salvation anymore. That is a part of the kingdom. We're always talking about how Jesus died for us. He gave us entrance to the kingdom. But he wants us to learn to be citizens of the kingdom. And listen, I've been a citizen a long time of the kingdom. I mean, I'm ancient in the kingdom here on earth. But I didn't know how to exercise my rights as a citizen because I was into religion instead of being into the kingdom of God and manifesting the kingdom of God on earth. That sets you free. And plus, religion has a lot to do with making people feel guilty because they're not getting saved. So, oh, well, you're going to go to hell. Or, you know, you're not really with God because you're not coming to church. And let me tell you, being in the church is essential. It's imperative that we gather together, that we come together. But what the Bible says, not to forsake the assembling of ourselves. Why is that? Because we're coming to the embassy. And there again, a kingdom has an embassy, and a kingdom has a representation that gathers together to encourage each other to learn and to be equipped.
Yes.
That's what equipping really is. Equipped not just to learn religion and the history of religion, mm-hmm. or the future of religion. You know, there's a lot of religions, mm-hmm. and there's a lot of do's and don'ts and regulations. And of course, there is laws in the kingdom. But what we're talking about is higher than that. It's higher than just do's and don'ts. Mm-hmm. It's living the actual manifestation of God through our lives on earth. And we think, well, that's so difficult. Not in kingdom language, it isn't. Mm-hmm. So the church is essential because we encourage each other. It's an embassy.
Yes. Yes.
So it is important that in church we don't raise the importance of church more than we raise the importance of kingdom. Mm-hmm. That's why the church is here. Yeah. Isn't that right?
We have seen that a lot.
It's not about come to my church,
yeah.
or
right.
we're growing in our church, you know, or the building. You know, God given us a building. Praise the Lord.
Yes.
That's great.
Yes.
That's the cherry on the top.
Mm-hmm.
But we are the church.
Yes.
So we gather together, whatever the spiritually gather together, in Jesus' name,
mm-hmm.
there is the church,
mm-hmm.
right? There you are. So, and the church does have a structure because it's an embassy.
Mm-hmm.
We've got to have an authority. And that doesn't mean that, you know, we're going to treat authority, her or him, like the Pope.
Mm-hmm.
They are just people that are being used and function in different callings, in like the fivefold, like
mm-hmm.
a pastor, apostle, teacher, evangelist. All that is a part of the church.
Mm-hmm.
So when we understand that we cannot elevate the church higher than the kingdom, that's when we begin to understand that the kingdom is manifest through the people and not through a building.
Yeah.
Because sometimes when we get too taken up with a building and all we think of is where our church is going to build this huge building, we're all going to come, and it's going to, all of a sudden, the attention changes to this humongous thing we're going to do. And all of a sudden, then we become a corporation.
Mm-hmm.
We have to meet the bills of building.
Mm-hmm.
You know, light's expensive, our water's expensive. You know, we have to bring more people so that we can, you know, maintain this monstrosity we just built, you know. So it's not about that. Yes, God can give you a great big building, but you know what? It's his.
Mm-hmm.
He pays for it. He orders it. God always pays
yeah.
for what he orders.
Yeah.
So it's not so the building cannot manifest anything. And the people just gathering in a building are not going to manifest anything on earth. I mean, they're probably going to do good in the community. There's a lot of organizations that do that, and that's great. But our most important thing to do as saints of God is to manifest. Because we're manifesting God. It's like God walking around here
mm-hmm.
through us.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm not saying we're gods. Please don't go out there and say, you know, Sister Liz said that we're God. We got it works through us, and so that's how we represent in the best.
Well, you call us little God. Oh.
Well, that's true. that's we came from him. He made us in his mm-hmm. image. Of course,
mm-hmm.
we're like him,
mm-hmm.
right?
Mm-hmm.
So salvation is just the beginning and the entrance to the kingdom of God. It focuses primarily on the way in which people may gain citizenship in the kingdom, but few really know much about it. And that's my story. That's my husband's story. And that doesn't mean that we didn't do anything good or that it didn't matter, because we're still citizens. We just don't have the knowledge of that. And so therefore, we don't have the confidence to manifest God the way he should be manifest, because we are depending on other things. And I'm telling more people they should get saved, and oh my goodness, I didn't tell anybody last week,
mm-hmm.
you know. So we start feeling the guilt, and that's what religion does.
Mm-hmm.
As a matter of fact, that's what religion depends upon,
mm-hmm.
guilt,
mm-hmm.
so that you can come.
Mm-hmm.
You can come Sunday, Okay, God's going to get you, you know. So that's all very superficial. And of course, God cares and he speaks to us, and the Holy Spirit lets us know because our spirit witnesses with the Spirit of God. So it's a little blur. To me, it's like a blur vision to think of it just salvation, because you're not seeing the whole picture. You're just seeing certain things, and tunnel vision.
Yeah.
We just believe in salvation and nothing else.
Mm-hmm.
And there's so much more, and that's what takes us to our next level as citizens of the kingdom. And to see really the kingdom properly, we need to go to Genesis 1:1. Because God created his kingdom then on earth.
Mm-hmm.
What did he do? He, in the beginning, Genesis 1:1, in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth.
Mm-hmm.
By right of creation, God owns the earth and the heavens.
Mm-hmm.
Because the word says he created the heavens and the earth.
Yeah.
If you create something, let's say you're the manufacturer of something you created, you own it.
Mm-hmm.
You own it. You can put it out there and say,
that's right. Oh, it's
as simple as that.
Mm-hmm.
He created it. He's the owner of everything.
Right.
And the kingdom God includes.
You know, one of those, Allah. Uh-huh.
Uh-huh. Everything.
It's so simple.
Isn't it? So he loves
it.
Us.
He created, he owns it.
He owns it. He owns everything.
Yes.
Because it says that God created in both heaven and earth.
Mm.
The kingdom then includes not only heaven, because see, a lot of people think or believe that God's in heaven.
Mm-hmm.
I agree with that. That's his realm,
mm-hmm.
right? God created heaven, and God is in heaven. But God is also here.
Mm-hmm.
And he's here through us only.
Yeah.
Because he lawfully came back on earth like he was with Adam before. And his kingdom that he created, that he owns.
Mm.
Right? But somebody sort of taking residence in this earth and became the ruler of the power of the air. So therefore, God has to come in legally. He always does everything legally.
Yeah.
He couldn't step on earth himself, or we will be all the lights too much for our elements on earth.
Even
he
though
made.
He's the owner,
he's the owner.
Even though he's the owner, he has total right. You know what I mean?
But somebody else has taken residence.
Yes.
Somebody else has illegally tried to claim that this is his. We see that happening on earth on every realm possible, right? So and that's the power that deceives, and that's the power. You know, Jesus didn't have to battle Satan so much as he did the religious people, right?
Yeah.
We don't either.
Right.
That's exactly what we have. The religion is very is very established since the very beginning, because Satan knows that people that are religious are very dedicated to their religion, and so he doesn't care if they do that, because they're not going to do anything, you know, that could be give people purpose other than his life.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why the earth is so messed up. That's why so many things are going wrong, because the enemy still thinks he's got it. And we, the more we manifest ourselves or manifest God on earth,
his kingdom,
his kingdom, the more that these other powers are going to dissipate.
Yes.
They're going to disappear because when this kingdom preaching over all the earth is done, then we win.
Mm-hmm.
We're already winners, but we have work to do.
Yes.
Right? And you know what? God does the work through us, so we don't have necessarily say, well, how am I going to do the kingdom? Just let God do it to you. Let's relax. be at peace. He will do it. Can somebody keep the time for me, because I'm not used to, I guess, mm-hmm. what time, what it till?
20 minutes.
Yeah, I think. So, so how much do I have?
3 hours, 4 hours, 5 hours. I don't have time here.
So. We want to do it before. We start at 7, so I say at 7, let's say 7:30, 35.
Well, when you finish there.
Okay, well, it's a lot, but I just, I talk a lot, so that's one thing. I mean,
well, that's true,
you don't put a woman.
You're manifesting.
Yeah, I'm manifesting. That's true. Amen.
And you're helping us.
But I also want to do.
Doctor Rick is not here today, so don't worry about it. We can do.
He's not here, so we can do whatever.
You're the boss today.
Okay, so he owns everything, but right of creation is important.
Yeah.
It is important to understand that creation was pronounced good. This is a very good point, because creation was announced good by God. He said, it is good. I know that because he did something. He created something. And he said to himself, this is good. I just think that's awesome. Have you ever done something? And it turns out really good.
Yeah.
And you go, I did that. This is great.
This is good. Yeah.
You know what? Some people have told me, you know, incredulous people, that why does God pat himself in the back and say, I did this. I'm the God of, who can know the expanse of the earth? Nobody. And why does he give himself so much credit? I'm the one that we should do. Even Jesus said, worship God, right?
Mm-hmm.
So why does, well, I'll tell you why, because he made everything, because he made us, and he was very happy with his creation, and he's very happy with us. So yes, when I create something, I want to tell you this, I did this, because I love, because he loved us. So I think it's marvelous.
That's a good point. He created, he made us to be like that too, so. We should be happy when we create something, because it comes from him.
I did that, you know, God, of course, with the help of the, with God, but he who is God has made it. And I think he said, it is good.
It is
he good. Said that to himself. I mean, Jesus and the Holy Spirit were too, because he says, let us make this, right?
Yes.
So he created and he approved it because it was good. Oh my goodness. I just think. Wow. I mean, yes, that's why we are good. So when he finished, he pronounces it very good. Genesis 1:31. All the dirt, rocks, water, plants, animals, and man himself were not created but an evil, but God. And the reason why I say that is because the fact is that many religions do not believe that. They believe that we were born in this world evil. Where the, like, that matter is evil. I'm trying to put it into words that I have heard when it says we were born sinners. When we come into this world, we were born sinners.
Isn't that an
but we weren't created sinners.
Okay.
We were born of the flesh sinners. In other words, when we're a baby, but the thing is that God created us good, and that's why we're here, to manifest God's creation.
Oh, that's good. Oh, that's so
that
good.
We're good.
Yes.
That he said we are good. That's, I tell you what, if you don't hear anything else, hear this. The basis for living religion and clinging to kingdom is that God said that it was good, that we were good, and everything else was good. Doesn't look good. I mean, everything that decays and dies, including our own body, but that's not how God initially created us. So we have to believe that in our spirit, in our minds, and in our hearts, because we are not just this person you're seeing right now. We are beings. We are not angelic, but heaven. We're better than angelic beings.
That's right.
We're heavenly beings.
Yeah.
And so therefore, we were created good. Mm-hmm. But even with flesh on us, mm-hmm. even that, because Adam had flesh,
mm-hmm.
Adam had a body, he was matter,
mm-hmm.
he was the real on earth.
Mm-hmm.
You know what? Jesus had flesh, mm-hmm. and he was good. We all good.
Mm-hmm.
And that's how we're trying to peel all these layers of religion to find out that we, right, that we are good.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why it opens up a whole nother world
mm-hmm.
about that's what manifestation is.
Mm-hmm.
We're manifesting ourselves of God.
Mm-hmm.
So therefore, when somebody sees us talk with us, they immediately start getting that vibration that we give out,
yeah.
that we are here, we are good, and you can't call me evil,
mm-hmm.
and you can't call me bad because I don't have any of that.
Mm-hmm.
Does that mean I don't sin? No. But I am intrinsically good,
yes.
not bad.
Mm-hmm.
So what when religion gets you is
mm-hmm.
you're bad,
oh,
you're
yeah.
a sinner,
yeah.
you
mm-hmm.
have, you know, a history of alcoholism in your family, and then they start going through all the fleshly things
mm-hmm.
that our ancestors, our father, our mother, or we have done.
Or even people they know you. Oh yeah,
mm-hmm.
I remember you.
Exactly. I remember you. They told Jesus
they
that.
They want to put the shackles back again.
Exactly. And they tried to do that to Jesus,
mm-hmm.
saying, oh, isn't he the one that was over there that was,
mm-hmm.
you know. So that's what the enemy wants to do. If he doesn't cause you to go and steal and cheat and do
mm-hmm.
all that, he will cause you to be ignorant about
mm-hmm.
who you are.
Mm-hmm.
Because then you won't have victory on earth.
Mm-hmm.
You can say you have victory all you want, but if you still believe that I'm a sinner saved by grace, yes, I know that we've been saved because that's the entrance to the kingdom,
mm-hmm.
our knowledge. But we're already good. We're just finding out how good we are. And I think that's marvelous. Like God said to himself, this is good. So we are not in evil bodies.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, we are not. We were good, altogether good. I know a lot of people disagree with that because they are
mm-hmm.
still in religion, but that's okay. God is the
mm-hmm.
one. I don't bring you revelation.
Mm-hmm.
I just bring you my testimony and what I know. God will bring you the revelation and show you who you
mm-hmm.
really are in Christ. So in order to understand the gospel of the kingdom, we must understand that matter is not intrinsically evil. It was created good and reflected the artistic ability and character of his creator.
Mm.
Mm. Bam! That's it. That's it. We are these beings that are like God, and we have light like God. So we're little lights.
Mm-hmm.
He's a big
yeah.
light. We
yeah.
couldn't take it.
Mm-hmm.
None of us in the flesh could take it. Moses couldn't take it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, to see God come back,
yeah,
because it is too much. So therefore, he sends us, and he gives us all this. So we get this light. There is a lot more to our body than just chemistry.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yes. We are also energy.
Mm-hmm.
We're also electricity, energy, light.
Mm-hmm.
Have you seen those glasses that can soldiers look through
mm-hmm.
and see people? They were light
mm-hmm.
because there are certain kind of
mm-hmm.
glass or a certain kind of glasses,
like
the goggles,
night vision.
Mm-hmm.
Night,
night vision.
Yes.
Yeah.
So where we show up as lights
mm-hmm.
because we are. It's just that, you know, the deceiver has made so many things that we don't know and that we can't see.
Yeah.
In the natural, to scare us, to
mm-hmm.
have us all serving him.
Mm-hmm.
Even if we don't say we worship him, if we are ignorant, then we can't see the light. And the light is what gives us away
mm-hmm.
as citizens of the kingdom. I want to say here, this is not in my notes, but I want education it's so widespread throughout the whole earth, the education of men.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm not saying not to get educated. I believe we have the foundationals of math and science and all that, right? But the enemy has diluted so much of that, that education has become a, what do you call it when you, indoctrination.
Mm-hmm.
And the enemy has all these points that he's drawing people to.
Mm-hmm.
But we know that the light of the gospel, the light of the gospel of the kingdom, it's powerful. And it can just, you can just be like a laser to the heart of the person. Because I cannot give that. I can only give my light. But when I manifest God, God takes over. God is the one that goes through like a laser through me. Know that I have it, God does. And can just by saying hi to somebody, they can open up. Because it's the Holy Spirit that draws men. We don't draw men.
Right.
I mean, that's something we got. That's another thing about church. Is that we gotta get people saved. They gotta come, and we gotta count them, and we have how many, and how many were saved, you know.
Yeah.
And I think that's, you know, it's good to bring people to something good, but then open their eyes so they can see themselves as something good.
I believe if they really truly say exactly what Jesus will say, there will not be so many people in there, you know, just say, because most of the people, I mean, most of the thing that I have heard is, you know, come so you can receive salvation, so you can, you know, when you die, you go to heaven.
Yeah.
That is not true. That is not true. I mean, I'll be like, okay, and then still living like whatever. And I did that. I said, yeah, because I was going through a lot of, you know, stuff that I said, Lord, you even save me or kill me, because I don't want to deal with this anymore. And you know, but nobody told me the basic of, you know, it was just salvation. You say yes and receive it and believe it.
And tell others, and then they do, and they tell somebody else.
And read the word and then do this. And
but
then,
where is the victory? Where is the conquering? Where is the next level? Where we get totally set free, and really, really have that faith.
Yeah.
It's not difficult to have faith, really, when you really live in that realm.
Well, it is. You have to give your life.
Yeah,
nobody said that before.
Yeah,
this is the first time I heard that. It's not just to say, "Hey, Jesus, I'm here. Yeah, I give you, you know, my finger." And you know, I take the rest. It's given the life. Nobody said that to me before.
And when you find the kingdom, it's like the pearl of great price. That's what it is.
When you
and
present
you
the kingdom
everything.
Like exactly like
it,
you don't have to even preach it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? You don't have to
you give it.
I mean, you want
it's light. That's why Jesus said that we is the light, but we are the light too.
Yes.
He made us lights.
Yeah.
And so a lot of people are living in darkness, even though they say they're saved. And I don't doubt that they are, and that they have found something. They found the entrance. Now, come on in then. Come all the way in, right? Okay, so when you go through Moses in the Old Testament, that was designed to fail. God already had it designed to fail.
Mm-hmm.
Why? So that we know what didn't work.
Mm-hmm.
So that we know that's the old covenant. So that you can see clearly that the new covenant is much better.
Mm-hmm.
We don't discard the old covenant as it's saying, in the, you know, it's never existed. It's existed so that we can see.
Mm-hmm.
So that we can see how it's not supposed to be, that religious part.
We learn from that.
We do. Mm-hmm. And God knows it because he made us. He knows how we learn. We learn to cling to religion.
Mm-hmm.
And he says, this is what happens when you cling to religion. You you pass away. The old covenant put the responsibility. So that, no, that's okay. Mm-hmm. The old covenant put the responsibility upon human flesh to accomplish the purposes of God and to bring perfection, which they cannot possibly do, right? It failed. And so the old covenant was abolished in favor of the new covenant. The responsibility upon Jesus Christ to accomplish the purposes of God and to bring perfection to all of us. The outworking of the new covenant is not yet complete. Why? Because why we're here. That's why we're here. Mm-hmm. To complete the work that Jesus came to do. Mm-hmm. That's why he said greater things than this would you do, because your eyes are going to be open. Mm-hmm. He says, I'm going to my Father, but I leave you a comforter. I give you a revelator so that he will guide you into all truth. It's the same truth, right? The truth never changed, but we are to complete that task, and that's why we're here. Are you doing what you're supposed to be doing? Are you being who you're supposed to be on this earth? That's a better question. Because me and the being that I have and the gifts that I have, the talents, everything, is are used to manifest. Not to build the building, not to bring people in. No, people will come. Mm-hmm. Yeah, the Bible says that the Holy Spirit draws the people. I mean, even if I have a business, if I have that, the Holy Spirit will bring the people. The United States of America, I'm telling you, I was good. Today I was on my job, which is in different places at different times. And I was telling this lady, we were going to one of the aisles at Walgreens. We were at the pharmacy there doing an interpretation. That's what I do. And she says, oh, is that flowers? And I looked at one of the aisles and said, yeah, it's flowers. I don't know why. They were just plastic, but they were made different. And they were really cute. I'm thinking, I'll tell you what, only in America do you have aisles and aisles of toys that look like, you know, they're great. They're great creations, right? So we have that inside of us to create things to help people, to help, you know. In America, it's so used to, you got to do this, you got to do that, and you have talent, you're going to, let's get it all out and make something out of it. And that's good. That's a good thing, because we do have them. But in the kingdom, that transforms all those gifts and talents so that we can use them to manifest God on earth. So the last thing I want to say is that, of course, we're still in the New Testament. We're still in the covenant. And we know that everything is going to pass away except for God's word. Right? But right now, we are on that. And we are seeing a lot of things, a lot of corruption around us. And that's why more than ever, we need to be manifesting on earth so that the end can come, the end of the age. So every kingdom, this is like going to the next thing that maybe we can do later. But I also teach on that already. But every kingdom must have four basic elements. A kingdom has a king, citizens, laws, and territory. And each one of those, we can go through that, you know, in another time. So a kingdom on earth, which we are, should have those four elements. There is no kingdom on earth that doesn't have those four elements. You have to have a king and the citizens, the territory, and the law. Because that's how we govern ourselves on earth. With the law matter in heaven, you know what? God says that his law will never pass away. So we are just advancing. I'm not going to sit here and say, well, how is it going to be? I wonder if we're going to, you know, we're going to have a wing, so we're going to have this or do that. You know, we're already in eternity. We already have eternal life. And we're already living that life. You know, we're just going to make a transition. And that's right now, what God has given us to do right now is what we need to be doing, manifesting God on earth on our time here, because we know that eternity has no time, right? If we are already eternal, mm-hmm. then that means while we're on earth, we have the time to do what we're supposed to do mm-hmm. to manifest God's kingdom. Mm-hmm. You know, if we don't understand it all,
yeah.
I mean, we will one day,
mm-hmm.
but we only understand what God tells us individually
yes.
and
yes.
as a group.
Yes.
That's why it's important that we belong to a group, to a embassy,
mm-hmm.
Where there is order,
yeah.
where there is structure,
yeah.
where we are equipped.
Yeah.
So this is the order of God. So that's why we respect authority, and we walk in that authority. So if we don't respect and we don't put ourselves under authority, then we won't have it. People say, "Well, God gives me authority. I can." Yeah, God gives you authority, but God gives you authority if you're under authority, earthly authority, because that's God's structure and that's God's order, right? So, well, I hope you got something out of this, and we will be, probably my husband will make a question or two out of that for those of you that are students,
mm-hmm.
and we love you. Thank you very much for listening, and what do we say?
Mm-hmm.